name is Bonile Mpele and you are back in this channel. Welcome fam, welcome. So today we'll be talking about ways in which you can maximize your income. How can you maximize what you currently have or what you wish you could have? So today we'll be talking about that, and I want to talk to someone who currently doesn't have anything in their pocket. Not like you have savings somewhere, saved and logged and fixed and so on. I want to talk to someone who doesn't have anything, like who needs that 50 rand that someone can give them. Unfortunately, no one will give you money because it's tough times. Everyone needs to work. So today I'll be talking about ways in which you can make money from 0 rand to 100 rand. How can you make money within that period of not having anything, or if you have a 10 rand, a 50 rand, and so on. So all the side hustles that I will name here want you to have 0 rand up to 100 rands. Let's stop at 100 rands, because it's easy to borrow 100 rands from someone and then you can also return that 100 rands back. So if you are really, really, really willing to start a side hustle, look into this side hustle that I'll just point out and take the one that will work for you. Remember, these advice are just my personal advice, and I'm not an advisor. This is just me helping a girl out, helping my brothers out. So you take it if it will work for you. Don't take it if you see that it's not gonna work for you. And either way, if you see that this is a waste of time for you in terms of making a 100 rand maybe each day, then you can skip that video. Come to the next one where we make millions, okay? Side hustle number one. I've just numbered the side hustle that you can take. It's just 6 side hustles that you can do with no money at all. All you need is yourself, the presence, the discipline, and knowing what you want. So hustle number one is preparing healthy meals. Prepare healthy meals and sell them to people. I would like to eat healthy. I would like to have in a healthy, balanced lunchbox at work, but I don't have time. I just take whatever that I can take in the house, then I go to work. So if you could, you can do the side hustle. It's in demand, because most of people, they're always in a rush. They're always in a go. So if you have time in your hands, just prepare meals and sell. Before doing that, on a business side, and advice that I can give from my personal experiences, never prepare anything if you don't have orders, because that will end up having to be a waste and you lose a lot of money. So whatever that you do, do it because you do have a client on board, okay? So how are you going to do that if there's no one? Firstly, advertise. Download Canva. With Canva, you are able to play around with your ideas. How much is a meal? What do you want to prepare? Like, you'll be preparing an ad in a way, and a poster of what you are selling, and then you post it on your WhatsApp. Remember, you do have data, you do have WhatsApp. So if you can watch this, you can do that. Download Canva, do a price list that you can do, include pictures and all that, and then post it on your WhatsApp. See what are the reactions from other people. Then when you get the first client, ask your first client to pay you before. They pay you before, then you go buy what is needed, you do, and then you sell. Then you have your profit, right? With your profit, the next client, you do the same thing. Like, that's how you go until you gain a client base where now you'll be making maybe 5 sandwiches in the morning and 5 lunch boxes, and then you go to a spot where you know that most of your clients are passing by, or most of your clients are there. Then you go there, you sell to them, and life goes on, right? That is number one. Number two, you can start a fitness boot camp. A boot camp does not need you to own a gym, right? If you know that you are passionate about exercising and you know that you're keeping up, you're keeping in the consistency, why can't you invite 5 people? Then you train them, right? Starting in with small exercises, and then more people, once than one person see that, okay, once I align with their side, they will come in join. Find a sport ground, find a backyard in your own house, then you invite people that you're saying, and you say that you are willing to offer them trainings. Let's say you are, say, you charge 100 rands per person for the whole month. Remember, here we're building. So if you're building, you cannot build today and finish the house today. So you need to start in by preparing your site. You need to put in your foundation. Then you build walls, you leave it to dry, you put windows, you put in, like, the way that the house is built. Okay, I'm not an expert in that side. But what I'm saying is, you cannot charge people 500 rands simply by just making them jog around your yard. So now you are building a relationship with the people who you have invited. So let's say you're asking those people to pay you 100 rands for you to train them, right? So what you're going to do, let's say you have 5 people each month. You have 5 people that will give you 100 rands just for you to train them. So now in a month, you have 500 rands. And if your service is good, this person can bring in a partner. This person can bring in a partner. This person can bring in a partner. And all of them bring in partners. Now you have 10 people, which means now you have 1,000 rands only by simply making sure that 4 o'clock you are there. You're ready for the people. You give them what they're looking for. You give them what they are there for, of which you need to be consistent and you need to take that business as a business. You need to be professional, right? So now you have 1,000 rand in your hand with you using your own passion and your own skills. That is side hustle number 2. Then we are on side hustle number 3. You can start a mobile car wash. I would love that. Myself, I would love it because I hate going to the car wash. I hate it, like, I don't have a passion for it. So if you could, you can start a mobile car wash where you come to me, wash my car, I give you money. Then you go to the next person, you wash their car, they give you their money. Like, you should be able and be flexible to move around and do the work. That's how we all start. That's how I'm starting myself, because I am doing deliveries myself. I don't have a person that I've hired to say, okay, now I'm done packaging this order, now take this order to this place. I am mobilizing. So if you could, you can start that side hustle, and all you need is just an equipment to wash the car. You don't need all this big machine, unless if you have a relationship with another car wash where you can borrow a vacuum or you can borrow what to wash the car, then you bring in. But in basic terms, you just need a broom, a dustpan, you just need a soap, a sponge, a bucket, a polish, and a brush to polish the wheels. Then you need clothes, dry clothes, wet clothes. Then you're done. And that can even, a pep, the bucket is 13 rands. Dustpan and what is almost the same price as a bucket. Soap is 20 rands. Sponge, you can just take a sponge anywhere where you, like, sponge are always available in our neighborhood and all that. Like, you can get a sponge anywhere. You can take a cushion and then you cut, like, a cushion costs maybe 30 rands. You take your old cushion at home or your old pillow at home, then you take in a sponge from there. You take a cloth, a wet cloth, an old t-shirt, it washed perfectly. You can ask me, it washed perfectly. You take an old t-shirt, then you cut it half. The other one is to dry, the other one is to wash or to remove, like, stains, I don't know. But what I'm trying to say, in short, all of these things that I've mentioned, you can get them for less than 100 rands at Pep or any other retail shop. Try to look for reasonable prices, and then you can get this thing, and then you get your business going. Here I'm talking to someone who's sitting at home and does not know what to do with that 100 rands that they have, and, like, they don't know what they can do in order to multiply that 100 rands. So I'm here for that. And then we are on hustle number 4, side hustle number 4. Side hustle number 4 is a mobile salon. Again, with this COVID happening, the pandemic, I am so reluctant to go to the salons, of which that is where I cut my hair. And I find it hard for me to go to the salon. Firstly, it's packed. Secondly, it's not guaranteed that all protocols are reserved. So I just, for now, we need people that I can say, okay, I'm making an appointment for Saturday at this time and this time. This is where I live. Will you be able to come do my hair? Then the person pops in, they do your hair, you pay them. Because some people say, ah, I don't have cash, blah, blah, blah. And you make sure that you know your banking details by head. If someone says, I don't have cash, you say, you can transfer to this account. You can use this number to transfer to this account. So you're cool. You know that you have done the job and someone has paid you. Only to find that maybe you have spent 20 rand from your place to that person's place. And of which I don't recommend using money, your money, to do that. Because let's talk about someone who doesn't have a budget at this moment. So try to work around with clients that are in your location where you can always walk to deliver the service. So let's say now you have 5 clients that you need to do the straight ups for, and of which in Joburg the straight up costs around about 250 to 350 rand. So you come to my place, you do me a straight up for 350 rand. And then I like it. And then I call in Unati, come do your hair. She's here, right? You do Unati's hair, she pays 250. You do Eminati's hair, she pays 250. Now you're leaving my house with almost 1,000 rands. And I'm able to recommend you if your service is good and you were there on time, you did my hair perfectly, and you did my kids perfectly. I can also call in a friend. Do you need someone to come in for you? I know someone who can help. Then that's how you gain a client base. So remember, you just bath and then you went into a place, and then from there you did a job and then you got paid. That is how we are building wealth. You don't just wake up in the morning and you have 1,000 rand without working for it. So we are here for this, taking it step by step. I don't want to rush you guys and give you all these big tips in terms of how to buy property and all that and all that. Let's start in small. Build that 100 rand until it becomes something that you can use to buy in that Uber car, right? So we are on side hustle number 5. Sell something. Use that 100 rand to buy in your stock. Ne? I'll give you an example. With 100 rand, if I had 100 rand and I need to start a side hustle, I'll go into ShopRite. I buy 1 kg popcorns. They cost less than 20 rand. I think it's 17 rands. I buy popcorns, I buy a cooking oil. You buy in even your packaging things. It's either you start in small and package using the plastic, like those plastic for Amayobo, or like the transparent plastic. You can do that because you are starting in small. You go to the schools, you sell them. Then if you have more money, you can buy the other ones for packaging, which is the paper one. Remember, you can introduce people to new things. So put in your aromat into your popcorns and see the reaction. It's so nice. Then you can go to a spice shop. You get in those sour cream and chives. You get butter salt, spices. For only 100 rands, I'm still on a budget of 100 rands. You go home, ne? You make popcorns. Let's say you're not working. For a person who's not working, who's sitting at home and who has 100 rand currently, you buy the popcorns and all the things that I've mentioned. Then you wake up tomorrow, it's a weekday, there are kids going to school. You wake up around 5, you pop your popcorns, ne? You put them in a plastic. And then you go to the school in the morning. Around 7 o'clock, you are there at the gates, because most kids, that's the time that they arrived at. From 6:30 to 7, you stand in the gate. 2 rand popcorn, 5 rand popcorn, 7 rand popcorn. You made money. Let's say you come back home with 150 rand from the popcorns that you made, with the 100 rand as the capital. So now you have made 50 rand more on top of the 100 rands that you had. You go back, you buy again with the 100 rands, keeping the 50 rands. The next day, the whole week, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, you're doing the same thing. That will be me saying. Tip number 6, which is my last tip, that does not need you to spend anything. Do you have a space in your house, or do you have a space in your home where you can take care of 2 kids? Let's start with 2. I don't need you to go register a crash and so forth and so forth. Just ask a neighbor who is struggling, who wakes up in the morning, early in the morning, to drop off the child at the crash, to ask, Mikey, can I look after your son? Can I look after your baby? Ne? Remember, you're a neighbor and neighbor knows you. So what you need to do is to present yourself well and treat other people's kids with kindness. I will kill for my daughters. I will kill for my son. So if you don't treat my babies well, me and you will fight. So you need to have a heart of gold, because kids ain't no child's play. So you need to have that heart, like a loving heart, a heart that like usaphela kepilo, like uska dinner fast, because bana basinya, bana babizi. You won't have much time in your hands if you opt to take in that route of a side hustle. It does not need you to have any money. What you need is space where the kids can play, and you also have somewhere where you put them when they want to nap. So you look after those kids, you feed them, you train them, you let them play, you look after them when they're playing. Then the neighbor can give you maybe 500 rands every month to save for a startup. Then you have two kids, which means you have 1,000 rands in 1 month. That is me, guys, sharing what I can do with 100 rands or with no money in order to build in something that can be a ticket for me to do something big tomorrow. What I've learned is your network is your net worth. So build as many relationships as you can so that you are able to work with people and you're able to be assisted by people in order for you to grow, right? And some of the things you don't need to kill other people. You need to drop people's pockets for you to succeed in life. Like I'm saying, if you can start in with 100 rands and you sell in popcorns for only 5 rands, you don't need to make your popcorns 25 rands so that you can make money and drop other kids. No, people won't come support you if your daycare facility is expensive. We will not bring our kids there. If your car wash is not reasonable, we will not ask you to come do our car wash. We will not do that. So do everything in considerations that you are building for the future. You don't want to be rich today, or you don't want to have all the money in the world today. You are building. And don't forget, after you have done it all, so that you see what you're working for and to see what you're working on, 10 rands, even 1 rand goes a long way. If you made 1 rand as a profit, put it aside. Work on that capital that you had. If you have borrowed that capital, okay, it's fine. Return that capital back. Then you work on the first profit that you got, so that after you're getting more profit, you keep into mind that, okay, cool, this is how much I made each day. Then you write it down. Then you write down, okay, Monday, the what date, I made 10 rands profits. The second day, I made 30 rands. And all in total, in 1 month, how much did I make? I made almost 150 in 1 month. Then you take that money, you bank it. You'll be amazed. You will be amazed one day when you look back and think where you have started. So that is just me being short with my small and yana knowledge into creating something out of nothing. It has worked for me. Imagine what it can do for you. That is my cue. Bye.